Hello everyone, I am Kavita Kushwah, working as an assistant professor in Electrical Engineering Department of SISTec-E, Ratibad, Bhopal. Today in this lecture, I am going to start unit number 4, which is Frequency Response Analysis. In the previous units, means unit number 4, we have studied the time domain analysis of an LTI system, in which we find the output equation in terms of time and the output response with respect to time and some time domain specification like rise time, settling time, delay time, maximum peak overshoot and steady state error. So let's get started. The frequency response means the response of the steady state output of an LTI system for sinusoidal input. So if we have a sinusoidal input RT is equals to R sine omega naught T. आप कुछ books में इस magnitude R को A देख सकते हैं या M देख सकते हैं और this frequency omega naught को आप simple omega भी आपको किसी कई books में मिल सकता है ये. Okay, so it's depend on you कि आप इसे A लिखना चाहें magnitude को और frequency को omega लिखना चाहें. So this is our input, sinusoidal input, RT is equals to R sin omega naught T. Here R is the magnitude of the input and omega naught T is the frequency of the input. And the corresponding output will be this YT is equals to magnitude of the output means capital Y and the sin omega naught T plus phi. Here phi is the phase and omega naught is the frequency of the output. As you can see here, the sinusoidal output, the steady state output of the system having the same frequency as your input, but here different in amplitude and phase. For different amplitude or out, for different amplitude and different phases, your output will be different. And this amplitude and this phase is different because of the characteristics of the system. This is the definition of the frequency response. The magnitude and phase relationship between sinusoidal input and steady state output of a system is known as frequency response. If we take the Laplace transform of input and output, then the output will be this. The relation between input and output is this. Ys is the Laplace transform of your output yt and Rs is the Laplace transform of your input rt, and here Ms is the transfer function of the system. यहाँ हमने Gs generally हम जो अभी तक transfer function लेते आए हैं system का वो हमने generally Gs और फीडबैक सिस्टम का ट्रांसफर फंक्शन एच एस लिया है बट यहाँ हमने इसे एम एस मानना है. ओके, सो दिस इज द इनपुट आउटपुट रिलेशनशिप इन टर्म्स ऑफ योर लाप्लास. फॉर स्टडी स्टेट एनालिसिस, वी will replace s by j omega, because the frequency is somewhere related to the input, and the input is sinusoidal function, and the here omega is your frequency. So our input is sinusoidal, that is why s is replaced by your j omega. Now the equation will become this: y of j omega is equals to transfer function m j omega, and input signal is r of j omega. By writing the function in terms of your magnitude and phase, so the output in terms of phase and magnitude will be this. This is the magnitude of your output equation y of j omega, and the phase of the output equation is y of angle y of j omega. Now with a similar definition, we can represent the magnitude of output and phase of the output in terms of input and transfer function. So suppose we have a system, called MS, and this MS is the transfer function of the system, and if this is a transfer function, then this is your output means YS, and this is your input means RS, because transfer function is nothing but the Laplace of output divided by Laplace of input. So this output YS is MS RS, and this S is replaced by j omega, so it will become like this: y of j omega is equals to m of j omega r of j omega. So the magnitude of this output is y of mod y j omega, and mod y j omega is the function of mod of transfer function, mean magnitude of the transfer function, and the magnitude of your input. Similarly, phase relationship of the output is this: phase of the transfer function and phase of the input. This is the phase of the transfer function, and this is the phase of your input. So we can write this output . So capital Y, here we have already taken this capital Y is the magnitude of output, and this phi is the phase of the output. So this magnitude and phase will be this magnitude capital Y, a magnitude of the output is R, input ka magnitude and transfer function ka magnitude. Similarly, the phase of the output equation phi is your transfer function, magnitude of the transfer function. Now, if we analyze this for closed loop system, so we know that the closed loop system is this. This is the GS. Okay. This is the output means YS. this is your input RS and this is your unity feedback HF, negative unity feedback minus HF. So the transfer function of the closed loop system is defined by this. MS is the transfer function, and transfer function is the Laplace of output divided by Laplace of input, and this is your GS divided by 1 plus GS HS. When this system, this closed loop system subjected with the sinusoidal input, so in this transfer function S will be replaced by your j omega. So the transfer function for steady state, sinusoidal steady state, will be your m j omega is equals to g of j omega divided by 1 plus g of j omega and h of j omega. And the magnitude of this transfer function, as you can see here, mod of m j omega will be your mod of g j omega divided by 1 plus g j omega h j omega. And the phase of the transfer function is this, angle of mj, or I can say this is the phase of your output. So phi j is equals to, हमें इसका फेस निकालना है तो कैसे निकालेंगे. दिस इज द फेस, न्यूमरेटर पार्ट का फेस विच इज एंगल ऑफ जी जो ओमेगा, एंड डिनोमिनेटर पार्ट विल गोज टू हियर एंड इट विल बी योर माइनस ऑफ एंगल ऑफ वन प्लस, मीन्स माइनस ऑफ दिस डिनोमिनेटर, मीन्स फेस ऑफ दिस डिनोमिनेटर माइनस द फेस ऑफ दिस डिनोमिनेटर विच इज 1 plus gj and hj omega. Now there are some frequency domain specifications, just like your time domain, and we have studied some specification in time domain, and they are maximum overshoot and damping ratio, rise time, cycling time, delay time, and steady state error. There are some following frequency domain specifications. So the first is resonance peak. So this resonance peak is the maximum value of the magnitude. The resonance peak is the maximum value of the magnitude, and the magnitude was m of j omega. Okay, and the resonance frequency is the frequency where magnitude has a peak value. So the frequency, the resonance frequency, is the frequency at which the peak resonance occur, means वो फ्रिक्वेंसी जहाँ पे आपका पीक रिजोनेंस अकर होता है, या फिर हम बोल सकते हैं वो फ्रिक्वेंसी जहाँ पे हमें पीक वैल्यू मिल रही है मैग्नीट्यूड की. ओके, सो दिस विल बी अ बैंडविड्थ, एंड द बैंडविड्थ इज द फ्रिक्वेंसी एट विच मैग्नीट्यूड ड्रॉप्स टू 70.7% ऑफ down from its zero frequency value. In general, the bandwidth of a control system gives indication on the transient response property in the time domain. A large bandwidth corresponds to a faster rise time, since higher frequency signals are more easily passed through the system. So if we calculate the resonance peak and resonance frequency for second order closed loop system, it will be the, if we have a second order closed loop system, so input is R of j omega. Okay, this is your second order transfer function, and this is your output, which is y of j omega, or I can say y of s, and this is your unity feedback, negative unity feedback. So the closed loop system of second order system is this. This is the transfer function of second order closed loop system. Ys is divided by rs, input is equals to omega n square divided by s square plus 2 zeta omega ns plus omega n square. This is our transfer function of second order closed loop system. For the second order closed loop system, resonance peak, resonance frequency and the band rate are related to the damping ratio zeta and undamped frequency, or I can say undamped natural frequency omega n. So we will determine the resonance peak and resonance frequency for second order closed loop system. So first of all, this system must be subjected by your sinusoidal input because we are analyzing frequency response. So here, this is the transfer function of second order closed loop system. In this transfer function, we will replace s by j omega. So humne is transfer function, is second order closed loop transfer function mein s ko j omega ke saath replace kar diya. So transfer function m of j omega will be your omega n square divided by j omega square plus 2 zeta omega n bracket mein j omega plus omega n square by taking this omega by omega no omega n as u. So the transfer function will become like this: m j u is equals to 1 divided by 1 plus j 2 u zeta minus u square. Okay, हमने यहाँ पे क्या किया, यहाँ पे ओमेगा एन कॉमन ले लिया है. तो जैसे ही ओमेगा एन कॉमन लिया, दिस ओमेगा एन, दिस और दिस न्यूमरेटर ओमेगा एन विल बी कैंसल आउट. सो हियर क्या बचा, यहाँ पे तो वन बचा, यहाँ पे वन बचा, एंड दिस ओमेगा बाय डिवाइडेड बाय ओमेगा, एंड दिस ओमेगा स्क्वायर विल बी डिवाइडेड बाय योर ओमेगा स्क्वायर. सो दिस इज योर यू स्क्वायर, दिस इज योर यू, एंड दिस इज योर वन. सो ये इस तरीके से हमारा ट्रांसफर फंक्शन आ गया. द मैग्नीट्यूड एंड फेज ऑफ दिस ट्रांसफर फंक्शन आर, मैग्नीट्यूड क्या होगा हमारा, मॉड ऑफ दिस, दिस इज क्या है, ये क्या है, दिस इज द, इट कैन बी रिटन लाइक दिस. वन माइनस ऑफ यू स्क्वायर प्लस जे टू यू जीटा. सो दिस इज ए एंड दिस इज बी जे. सो मैग्नीट्यूड क्या होगा, 1 डिवाइडेड बाय अंडर रूट ए स्क्वायर प्लस बी स्क्वायर, मीन्स दिस ए स्क्वायर एंड दिस बी स्क्वायर. ओके, एंड द फेस इज माइनस, बिकॉज द this the phase, whole the phases, numerator ka phase 0 ho jayega and denominator ka kya kya hoga, minus, because ye upar jayega iska phase, so minus tan inverse b by a, aur b kya hai yahan pe hamara, b a hamara 2 u zeta and a hai hamara 1 minus u square. So this is the phase of this transfer function. Now the resonant frequency is determined. As we know the definition of the resonant frequency, the frequency at which magnitude peak occur. So for peak value of the magnitude, we will differentiate this magnitude with respect to normalized frequency u. This is the normalized frequency u. U is nothing but your omega divided by omega and normalized frequency. तो हम इस magnitude को peak, इस magnitude का peak निकालना है, और उस peak से हमें क्या मिलेगी, resonance frequency. तो उसके लिए हमें इस magnitude का differential करना पड़ेगा with respect to omega, and this differential will, इस डिफरेंशियल को हम पुट करेंगे इस इक्वल्स टू जीरो से, और जो फ्रीक्वेंसी की वैल्यू निकलेगी दैट फ्रीक्वेंसी इज कॉल्ड एज योर रेजोनेंस फ्रीक्वेंसी. तो इस तरीके से हमने डिफरेंशिएट किया विद रिस्पेक्ट टू यू. फ्रॉम दिस वी गेट दिस इक्वेशन. ओके, नाउ द this UR is the normalized resonance frequency, normalized resonance frequency, and our actual resonance frequency is this omega R is equals to omega N under root 1 minus zeta is what. This is the resonance frequency at which maximum peak occurs. Now the resonance peak, this is the maximum value of the magnitude, which is 1 divided by 2 zeta under root 1 minus zeta is square. So, for frequency response, we will plot magnitude spectrum and phase spectrum. The output is y of j omega is equals to m of j omega and r of j omega, and the magnitude is this and the phase is this. So in frequency response analysis, we will plot this magnitude spectrum and this phase spectrum. Here, as you can see, the resonance peak is the function of only damping ratio zeta and the phi, means phase, is the function of zeta and omega n, which is natural frequency. Here phi is your minus tan inverse 1 minus 2 zeta square under root divided by zeta. Let me write it again. This phi is your minus tan inverse under root 1 minus zeta square, sorry, 2 zeta this is 2 zeta square divided by zeta. Okay, this is your phase. Now, the formula of the van Wilt is this. This is the bandwidth. This omega, UB is equals to under root 1 minus 2 zeta square plus minus this 4 zeta ki power 4 minus 4 zeta square plus 2. Or you can just simply write like this, U square is equals to this. Okay. So here the frequency magnitude response and phase response. As you can see here, this is the magnitude and this is your phase. For different values of normalized frequency U, for when U is equals to 0, this magnitude become, your m become 1 and your phase phi m become 0. Okay, when U is equals to 1, then your phase become 1 by 2 zeta and phase become your minus of 90 degree. Okay, I can write minus pi by 2. And when your U is tends to infinity, then your magnitude will be 0 and phase will be your minus pi. Okay, so we can see here in the magnitude and phase plot, by varying U we can plot this magnitude spectrum and this phase spectrum. So jab hamara frequency 0 thi, means U 0 tha, tab magnitude ki value kya thi, 1. And when our frequency is 1, then the magnitude was your 1 upon 2 zeta. Okay, and when U become infinity, then magnitude become 0. So this magnitude curve is tends to 0. Okay, now if we plot the phase spectrum, we have phase plot. So phase is when U is 0, the phase is start from your 0 degree. So this is your 0 degree when U is 0. When U is 1, the angle is, the phase is minus of 90 degree. So this is minus of 90 degree. When U tends to infinity or U is equals to infinity, then magnitude become 0 and phase become of minus 180 degree. This is the 180 degree. This is 180 degree. Okay, this is 180 degree. So ye hai hamare magnitude plot and this one is the phase plot. There are some advantages of frequency domain analysis over the time domain analysis, and these advantages are, the first one is, the frequency response of a stable open loop system can be obtained experimentally. The second one is, this approach is simple and accurate. This method can be used to find the absolute as well as relative stability. The effect of noise and disturbance and the parameter variation are relatively analyzed. Okay, there are some disadvantages of frequency response analysis, and these are, Obtaining frequency response practically is fairly time consuming because we need to convert the transfer function, the output equation in terms of j omega, then we need to separate magnitude and angle. Okay, so this has become time consuming. Okay, this method are applied to linear system, and the last disadvantage is for large time constant frequency response method is not convenient. Okay, for there are some techniques for frequency response analysis, and this frequency response techniques are, first one is polar plot. First one is polar plot. Second is Bode plot. These two, polar plot is the frequency response of an LTI system, and Bode plot is also a frequency response, or I can say frequency plot of the LTI system. The Nyquist criteria, the third one is Nyquist criteria. Nyquist stability criteria is the method to find out the stability of the system. Okay, I hope you all understand this. If you have any query, then you can comment in the comment section. Thank you.